Today we are assembling a generator that can source an entire house. We have tried to make one in winter, but really failed that time. Carefully! And now we have decided to make it much bigger, a giant wind turbine. We have found an enormous plastic sewer pipe in this purpose, it is 200 mm diameter. It wasn't an easy task to get it in my town. According to my calculations, we are likely to make some great 1.5 meter blades out of it. And eventually a weak wind of 10 meters per second will give us 1.5 kilovolts of energy that we need. There is the cardboard we are going to make the stencil of. Then we'll just put the stencil on the tube and that's it. Nextly I will make like this, and we've got some fine flat cardboard trousers. And of course I'm just kidding, my comrades. There is the stencil we needed. Well now, we've made it, and now comes the installation process, and we don't want it fall again, thus we're rising it in two parts. There comes the motor, it is the one we've made last time, out of the electric bike motor. This motor is used just perfect, because it has an awful lot of neodymium magnets and windings, so it will give us much power out of slow torque. Firstly, we're attaching the motor to this mast, then we will connect the blades to it. Just look at them, the 1.5 meter blades, it's hot over there. These keyboards are the wind stabilizers here. Now the blades will always be facing the wind, whenever it comes from. And the motor hands on the wheel hub, by the way. Pay attention, there is almost no wind on the ground. But you can see that there is some on the roof. Should I help you maybe? Oh damn it! What was that sound? Oh, that just a pipe went a little down. You know, there is a special technique of walking on the roof. There are the greased seams, and you must step only on them. Or else you will just break the seams on the roof, it will start to leak and stars would kill us. Where are you going? Go and bring there the fan. Fan? I've just got too involved in talking, you know? Yeah, got it. There it comes, the creation moment! I just admire how big is that one! Here is the hardest part, he is spinning it to connect the blades. Does it go well? No. It doesn't stop spinning with wind. Oh yeah! It is going to catch the wind! And it's the first spinning! Oh my gosh, that is really fast! Though there isn't much wind here today, that's a beastie wind generator. And there is the wire, here it goes under the roof here, and it goes this way then, and it meets the summer kitchen here. Okay, let's measure up the voltage we've got. Output, input. Connecting, it's 37 volts. Cool enough, but that is without any devices sourced out. There will be connected an accumulator, so it will give out less. Now I've connected here 7 of 90 watts and 12 volts bulbs. Let's see ourselves how brightly this generator will light them up.
Opa!
As you see, they do light pretty well. And sure, the brightness falls. Oh, there's a little more now. Sure, the motor slows down. Wow, the wind has just given some power, and they light really well. Anyway, this wind generator was made to charge up the accumulator. Then the voltage will go to the inverter. And now let's connect the inverter to the system. I have also connected these two testers. This one shows the voltage rate of the battery, and this one is for charging percentage. Wow, it's 14, the accumulator is almost full. There comes almost 15, and that's a good sign. As I said, we've got an accumulator here. So, this wind generator will source all it needs even when there is no wind. We don't really need 12 volts, we need 220 of course. Let's check out what we've got. Well, there is energy, nice. And now let's try to eat something very greedy for voltage. Let's make the dream of sourcing the entire house with green wind energy come true. I have connected these two old TV forks, just like this. Then I plug one end in the socket and another in inverter, and as a result, the voltage from the inverter will be connected to the house electric net. But there's one thing needs to be done. Before doing it, you must screw out all the fuses and turn off the main energy lever. We do it to prevent any short circuits and disconnect the electricity provider. Last move. Let's try it. I think that's it. The light is on. Let's see around the house and check how everything is working. That all is working, and even the ventilation system works well. All's on fire, I can start repairing my car right now. Well, the light works perfectly. Let's try to store some harder stuff. Let's see now. Oh, okay, I see it. Is it satellite? No. And there's the light. Where's the piggy? Oh, there you are. This power is even more than we expected. Even with the slow torque, this energy is enough for the entire house. But when the wing is too strong, we have to use the extra energy for heating. Wind generator is a nice green solution. Unlike the solar plant, this generator is really cheap and it works perfectly even when there is not much sun, in winter or fall for example. The wind generator has only one flow. It is extremely useless when there is no wind. We're going to make the giant lithium battery to cover this flow. But first we have to check out how safe to use these lithium batteries, and we will make a crash test. Don't miss this one. Subscribe, share with your friends, your attention makes us work better and faster. I salute my patrons and other viewers.